After scaling more than a dozen companies, four of which are eight-figure companies, and helping more than 100 other entrepreneurs to push through these new levels of growth, I'm sure that the fastest way to grow any business in any industry and in any economy is this: avoid mistakes that normally kill growth. I know that's simple, and I know that you're going to hear gurus tell you, oh, mistakes are essential, but I promise you this, you have 10 competitors around you right now who are biting at your heels and one good promotion away from overtaking you, and the seconds that you save by not getting slowed down by mistakes is going to determine if you will succeed or if you're going to be constantly struggling to stay ahead. I'm a firm believer that the speed at which we grow is directly determined by how fast we can learn lessons and then systematize those lessons so that we're not doomed to keep repeating those lessons over and over and over and over again. So what I want to give you here is an overview of eight mistakes that I made scaling my first business. That way, you don't have to learn the hard way, because each of these were very costly and stressful, and you may see my eye twitch a few times when I'm going through them and I'm remembering this shit. So I apologize, but the very first one is trying to learn every new productivity software. Now, there's a learning curve to every single new app or software that comes across the board. And your teams, especially if you're dealing with vendors and independent contractors, may tell you, oh, we need to use Basecamp, or we need to use, you know, Scrum, or we need to use this or that. And a lot of those are outstanding for them to be using, maybe even for people inside your organization to be using. But for you to learn those apps or those pieces of software will slow you down and take your mental bandwidth away from what really drives your growth. If you've watched any of our videos in this series, you know that I'm a firm believer that you've got some kind of stupid human trick. You've got something that you are so very, very good at. That's why you've earned the spot as owner in your business. And the more we can get you to focus on that, 80% of your time focused on that, 20% of your time focused on the other stuff, 80% of your time focused on your powerful stuff, 20% of your time focused on the other stuff, 80%, 20%, 80%, 20%. The more we could get you there, the faster we could get you growing. The second mistake I made was hiring inexperienced people instead of paying for real talent. I will, from this point forward, hire used, not new. I want to hire experience. I would rather pay for experience than go out there and pay the price for hiring somebody who I have to then train and then retrain and then retrain, and then slowly after 3, 4, 6 months, or in a larger organization, maybe after 12 months, that's when I could figure out if they really are the perfect fit for us. Now, I want to hire somebody and have momentum already started. I want to hire somebody and have them bring a Rolodex of relationships with them. I want to hire somebody and have them so smart that they're training me and my team on how to improve what they're good at inside of our company. That's huge, and that has allowed us to escalate significantly faster than most other companies around us. The third mistake that I made early on was not training leaders, just getting employees or just building teams. Now, one leader, I promise you, can change everything in your business for the positive. And I've said this over and over and over again. Time spent developing leaders has probably been the most profitable use of my time in any business, no, whether it's in the legal industry or in the media industry or in the publishing industry or in the health industry or any of the other industries that I've been in. Developing leaders in there has been transformational to us, and it's helped them to develop teams underneath them so that I could pull away and so that I could work on other ventures, or I could think bigger and grow the company doing other things. So that's huge. The fourth mistake that I made was, and this is a big one, and it's something that I see often, but I'm embarrassed about it. It's that it was allowing employees to stay on even after they've stopped performing. And it, by far, that's the worst decision that you could make, because it destroys your culture. When you have an employee who is not performing, what is happening is the other employees on your team or the other vendors or independent contractors or anybody else that you're working with sees that. They always see the weak link. And then their performance drops down to the performance of the weakest link, number one. Number two, they lose respect for you. Because when you have A players on your team, when you have people who are truly driven, who drink the Kool-Aid with you every single day, who really want to grow and have a passion for growing this company, when you have that kind of a person in there, and they see that you putting up with somebody who is not at that caliber, they lose respect. right? And this minute they lose respect for you, that's when all shit hits the fan. And you want to stop that. So please don't do that. That was a big lesson that we learned from, you know, after the first company. The fifth mistake was not knowing what to measure. Like, I literally went into business and didn't know what the heck to measure. Like most people, I looked at, well, how much money is coming in, or how much money is, you know, coming, or how many sales are coming in, or how many customers are we touching? Every company is different. However, there are key metrics. Normally in my organizations, 3 to 5 key metrics that I absolutely need to know. And when I know those key metrics, I can look at them every single morning and just see what the best use of my time is for that day. What do I absolutely need to measure, keep my finger on the pulse of, so that I know that everything else in the company is growing? If I know that those three or five key metrics are moving in the right direction, then everything else is probably moving in the right direction also. And here's a secret. The most important thing to measure in any organization that I've ever been part of is not revenue. It's, you know, profit is better than revenue, but it's not always profit either. It's the actions that create the most revenue and growth for your company. When you could knock it down, when you can reverse engineer your revenue and the number of sales you need to make and the number of customers you need to touch, when you can drop that down to the actual actions that create the numbers and the growth and the reach that you want to create in business, and you manage just those actions, your team will be a lot happier, you'll be a lot more fulfilled, and you'll literally be doing what is best for that small amount of time that you're spending in the company that day. Whether it's 3 hours, 4 hours, or 12 hours, it doesn't really make a difference. You've got to be focused on the most important use of your time while you're in there. And you can only know that when you know the actions that create the most growth for you. The sixth mistake that I made was not building to sell. Now, I don't care if you want to sell your company or if you don't want to sell your company. It's irrelevant. If you're not building your company to sell, then you're missing out on massive organizational structure, massive growth potential. Because when you build a company to sell, you become more streamlined, you become more systematized, you become far more focused on what really matters in that company. My challenge to you, if you've never thought about this one thing before, is to go out there and meet with a couple of bankers. Just don't do it now, just figure within the next 12 months. You'll go out there and you'll meet with a banker or two and say, hey, if somebody were to buy my company, if somebody came to me and they wanted X amount of money for my company, you got to go in there with an intelligent number, right? Like, let's just say if your company is worth $1 million, then go in there to a banker and say, hey, listen, if somebody is really looking to buy my company and they're serious, but they need funding from you and they want to buy this company for $1 million, just can you please go through the exercise with me and tell me, what are you going to want to see from me as a company? And they'll say, well, we're going to want to see this and this and this and this. And you don't have to do all of them, but if you do some of them, it will make you more organized. And the more organized you are, the more streamlined and the more profitable you will become. It's tremendously a different way to look at things, and it will improve your revenue and everything else inside your organization, I promise you. The seventh thing is not studying my competition. Early on, the very last thing I ever wanted to do was study my competition. Like, I saw them and I was mad at them because they were taking food off my table. Like, they were taking sales out of my pocket. But when I got really smart and I literally studied every aspect of them, if they're an online company, I would buy their programs. If they're an offline company, I would go in there and I'd shop them and I'd know their employees and I'd know where they're marketing and I'd know generally what people thought about them in the area. I want to know everything about my competition, and the smarter I became about each one of my competitors, the easier it was, the clearer it was to differentiate myself, my company, my marketing, and my branding in a way that literally attracted people like a magnet to my organizations and helped us grow significantly faster. The eighth thing, the last thing that I'm going to talk about today, the mistake that I made when I was scaling my first company, was not seeking advice from those who have already done what I want to do. And not just once, but multiple times. And I'm talking about mentors. Without a doubt, the number one most important asset in all of our past growth has consistently been access to people that I've got inside of my contact list. Smart people who have done it over and over and over again. And if you're just starting out, then that might mean just reading books or watching videos like this. And that's okay. That's how I started out. That's how everybody starts out. But once you get a little bit of momentum, then you're going to need to hire people, right? Look for people who have a track record of doing what you want to do. And again, not just once and not just twice, but look for people who have achieved what you want to accomplish multiple times, and then do whatever you need to get time with them. So if you're a novice, you're going to read books and videos. If you've got a little bit of momentum, you're going to go out there and hire somebody. But if you're really rocking and rolling in business, then you need a board of advisors or a board of directors. And if you're at that level, then you should watch our board series. We shot these a lot of videos. I think we've got 5 or 6 or a dozen videos in there. I'm not even quite sure at this point. And you'll see how I locate great board members. You'll see how I manage a board meeting. You'll see the paperwork that I use to set up boards in each of my companies. You'll get everything that we do to attract, manage, and create these boards that literally help us scale faster and more effectively. Now, those were 8 mistakes that I made scaling my first company. I probably made a lot more that I erased from my memory, but each of them cost me a lot of time and a lot of money to learn. But I've built, I've sold, I've acquired more than a dozen companies since then, and I never made those mistakes again. Because after making a mistake, we find a solution. And then we systematize it so that no company that I'm ever part of has to be slowed down by that mistake ever again. So initially, your goal is to learn from each of the mistakes so that you're not doomed to repeat them. But then after you start making money in business, your goal is to learn from the mistakes of others so that you can scale faster and more predictably.
No matter what stage of growth you're at, we all need an unbiased review of what's working and also what might not be working anymore in our business. Because the greatest cause of stagnation in any company, the reason most companies hit plateaus in their growth, is because they fail to see the roadblocks that stop momentum in its tracks.